What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByteByte.com, and in this video, I want to talk to you about something that I've been thinking about recently. So something that I've been working on, which you may or may not be aware of, is we're working on a new course on system design. And so I've been thinking a lot about system design, and one of the things that I realized was that there is actually a distinct difference between the two types of things that you need to learn when you're learning about system design. So when you're learning about system design, obviously we need to learn about different technologies. We need to learn about the different pieces that are going to fit into our system that we are building. But there are two different types of pieces that can fit into that system. There are the ones that you actually need to understand, and there are the black boxes. So I want to describe this so that you know, because when you are studying for your system design, the way that you prepare for these two types of things is different. And so there are a series of tools and a series of things that are actually like designed yourself. So when you are building a system, you are going to design the database schema. You are going to design what the API looks like. You are going to design the system architecture. And you actually need to deeply understand how these things work so that you can design them, right? Like you need to understand what the like data model is that you're using to design your database. You need to design like what are the specific columns of my database? What are the different tables that need to go into this database so that you have all of those pieces that can define your data, right? When you're talking about the system architecture, you need to know what are all the pieces that are going to go together. You need to be able to think through and kind of logically come to the work through how these things fit together. How are the different components in there? When you're talking about the API, you need to know what are the endpoints going to be? What is the data that people are accessing? And so that's one very specific type of skill, right? It's the skill of being able to work through something and design it yourself. But then there is also the black boxes. So there are so many black boxes that come up in system design, which are interesting because they're things you need to understand and they're things that you need to be able to work with, but they're not necessarily things that you actually need to know how they work under the hood. And so let's talk about a couple examples of what black boxes in system design might look like. A perfect example of a black box is a load balancer. Right? A load balancer is something where when you design your system, when you sketch everything out, you basically have a box there that says load balancer, right? And you might want to understand, for example, what are the different ways that I can do load balancing? Do I want to do a round robin, or do I want to do application-based load balancing, or do I want to do something completely different? Do I want to try and understand like what is the current load on each server, or am I just going to do it completely randomly? Right, you can understand these things and you can understand the purpose of the load balancer, but the details do not matter. The details of like how you implement that load balancer, how that actually ends up being a part of your system, is not what you are being tested on in your interview. The same is true for, let's say, an API gateway. Right, an API gateway, again, it's a component of your system that you need to know how to use in the context of your system, but it's not something that you are actually trying to implement yourself. And so it's important that you understand, why am I using an API gateway? What are the things that I am trying to accomplish with this? Am I trying to monitor? Am I trying to do rate limiting? Am I trying to just improve the security of my system by having an API gateway? Where does that API gateway actually go into my system? But it's still a black box. Right, and so I think a lot of times when I see people preparing for their system design interviews, what they do is they conflate these two and they think that they need to deeply understand each little thing. So for example, I hear a lot of people say essentially, well, I don't know how to build this because I've never done that before. I've never built a system where I had to like build it with a load balancer because I either am working on such a small component of the system at my company that I didn't have to touch that, or like we had a DevOps team that did that. That was my experience. Or I'm working on a personal project and my personal project just isn't at the scale that this actually matters, right? It's not at the scale that I needed to have a load balancer because one server was sufficient. And so I'm not familiar with specific load balancing technologies. I'm not familiar with that enough to feel like I can implement that as part of my interview. And so they spend all this time learning about specific technologies. They spend all this time learning about all these like nitty gritty details when that doesn't actually matter because that's not really what you're being tested in your interview. What you're being tested is you're being tested on your ability to design that larger system and put the pieces in place where they need to be. You want to understand why you're putting those pieces in place. That's again where it comes down to like with the black box, you want to understand what those pieces are, right? You want to understand what the properties are of a load balancer. You want to understand what the properties are of API gateway, but you don't need to understand the details of the implementation. You don't need to like spend all this time learning some specific tool to do that. And so when you're thinking about preparing for your system design interviews, think about, can you break things up into things that are actually things that you need to deeply know how to implement yourself and things that are black boxes? Can you remove those black boxes and understand the basics of them without actually understanding all the details? And so this is something that we're going to be, I'll be talking about this more in a couple weeks, but we're going to be sharing, I'll be sharing more about my course, which is coming out soon on system design. We cover all this stuff in a lot more detail. If you're interested in that and you want to get our free guide on the 50 most common coding interview questions, definitely go to bytebybyte.com/50questions. You'll get the guide for free and we'll share with you lots more information when the course is coming out. And with that, hope everyone's having a great day and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.